In this lesson, we use the polar array command to create copies of an object rotated around a center point. The polar array command is located on the Home tab in the Modify panel. You have to click the drop-down arrow next to Rectangular Array to access it. After starting the command, we will select the objects that we wish to create the array of. I'll start with this bolt. After pressing Enter to tell AutoCAD that I'm done selecting objects, I'm prompted for a center point. I will choose the center of this wheel. As you can see, AutoCAD automatically generates a polar array. This very likely doesn't have the correct number of objects nor the angle between them, so we will adjust these values. The Array Creation tab appears, and here I can adjust the number of items and the angle between them. In this case, I want 5 bolts, so I'll make that change. Taking a look at the objects on screen, I can see it updated to 5, and notice that these bolts are rotated as they're being copied around. I wish for each bolt to just simply be a copy of the original. So back up on the Array Creation tab, I'm going to deselect Rotate Items. Next, I'm going to create a polar array of the spokes. I choose the Array command again, select the objects, press Enter to tell AutoCAD I'm done selecting, then pick a base point. Once more, AutoCAD generates a polar array, and I will modify it. In this case, I want to have 8 spokes. So I will simply put in the value of 8. And notice that in each case, the angle between them is calculated automatically based on the fill angle. To finish up this drawing, I want to trim several of the spokes. However, this is an associative array, which allows me to go back and modify the array at any time. For example, if I want to switch to 7 spokes instead of 8, I can do so. Or I can switch back to 8. So when you have an associative array, it's really convenient that you can go back in and modify it at any point in time. However, it keeps me from doing certain things like trimming portions of it. So in this case, I want to break the associativity of the array. I do this with the explode command. On the Home tab in the Modify panel is the explode command. You can also type X, then press Enter at your keyboard. I'll select the explode command, select the array, then press Enter. Now these are each individual lines and arcs, which would allow me to come back in with the trim command to clean up these spokes. Let's take a look at another example. In this case, I have a chair next to a semicircle table. I wish to arrange several more chairs around it. I begin by choosing the polar array command, selecting the chair, then press enter. And I will pick the midpoint of the top line here as the center of my array. As you can see, AutoCAD automatically generated a polar array, and I am going to need to make some changes to it. I am okay with the number of items. I do want 6 chairs. However, instead of filling 360 degrees, I only want to fill the half circle, so I will enter 180, then press enter. As you can see, the chairs are actually going the wrong direction. So I can choose the Direction button up here on the Array Creation tab to instead force it to go clockwise. Finally, I want all of the chairs to face the same direction, so I will turn off the Rotate Items option on the Array Creation tab, then press Escape. Let's look at one more example. In this case, I want to create a polar array of this hole going around this center circle, but I also want to create several rows of it as well. So I begin with the polar array command, select the circle, then enter. Then I will pick the center of the part as the base point. I'm going to modify the number of items. I wish to have 4 of them in 360 degrees. And as you can see, there's this next section for rows. I can simply add in additional rows. So I want a total of 4. Then I can modify the spacing between them. And as you can see, I've now created a polar array with several rows. That concludes this lesson on the polar array command in AutoCAD.